As you can see from the background, today I'm going to be doing my desk and my workspaces. This is not my only workspace. I actually don't even really work here. So I'm going to show you guys what I finally came up with over here and show you where I got things from. Well, tell you where I got things from, but show you how I made some things and then just kind of give you guys a little bit of a haul slash tour. But I'm going to show you everywhere I work because, as you guys know, we are in these very different times. So having a good workspace at home is very, very important. So if that's something that you're interested in, go ahead and keep watching. If you're new to my channel, welcome. My name is Wayna and I make videos on home decor, but mainly rental friendly home decor. And if you have a rental space or a cute little small house and you need some tips, ideas, and hacks, then you should consider subscribing because that is all that I produce on this channel. So with that being said, hit that subscribe button and the bell next to it, and let's get into this video. So choosing the right shelves was such a hassle for this desk area for the longest. At first, I started off with this little picture ledge shelf from IKEA. It was white. I added some tape and tried to make it gold, and then that still didn't look right to me. So I ended up finding these really nice slim wall shelves from Home Depot, and I was able to put them up with actually no problem. The trick to actually getting this lined up appropriately is to use tape. So once I got those up, everything started to really come together, and I think I'm pretty satisfied with the way that these shelves look. All right, so moving on to this Dollar Tree hack. I've seen this a few times, so I figured I'd give it a try myself. And it's just taking a cooling rack from the Dollar Tree and popping off some of the wires and spray painting it. Make sure you spray paint in a well-ventilated area and use one of the many masks that you now own. All right, so I purchased this chair from Amazon and it was pretty easy to assemble. I'll tell you more about this chair. The detailed tour is coming soon towards the end of the video, so stay tuned. Alright, so I put together the base of the chair, and over here I have the arms, the seat, and the lever to adjust the chair. So this is pretty easy and straightforward. The arms tell you which way is the front, and then this tells you that this is the front. So I'm going to put the arms on first, and then the lever tells you which one is the front. So then I'm gonna put that on next, and then the back of the chair and the headrest. Let's go. Let's get this thing put together. I'm excited. Also, I wanna mention, if you do purchase this chair, the headrest, actually you have to disassemble it and then put the headrest in there. So that's why you can see where it didn't go down like it should have. Now, when it comes to organization, I actually purchased this really cool wall shelf for your folders from Amazon as well. And I'm just gonna use these really cool folders that I purchased from Target, and what I like about them is that you can label them. And what I'm doing here is I'm using a pencil first because I have the worst handwriting. So once I finished with the pencil, I just went back and retraced it with a black permanent marker and put a little heart on each one. So before, I had one side that was acrylic and I needed to finish the other drawer.
initially I was going to go with these pink plastic organizers, but I was like, nah, no. So I ended up switching it out, and you'll see how that looks. And I think it looks really neat. Here's a few items that I picked up from the Dollar Tree as well. And this is how everything looked once I was finished. Simple, but functional. So if you guys are running into the issue that most of us are, you're running out of workspaces. So a really cool alternative to a traditional desk is to purchase a temporary photo desk. And I really love this one because it has your USB plugs and an actual outlet plug right at the top of the desktop. And it can be folded up, and I literally use this in plenty of places. Like, I've used this probably in 4 different places in my apartment, but it's really nice to have a workspace wherever you need it. So I use my son's monitor sometimes when I want to get a lot of editing done, because he's usually on my iMac for school. And this is so easy, guys. If you have a monitor and a laptop and an HDMI cord, you can basically have 2 monitors or use a bigger monitor. It is such a upgrade. And I purchased this acrylic riser from Amazon as well, and I love it. Love it, love it, love it. It has the perfect height, and it's just so clean and modern. And I also purchased this pink wireless keyboard, and I really love this keyboard. It's comparable to Apple's Magic Keyboard, and all of the functions for shortcuts work exactly the same, not to mention it has a number pad. So this is how everything looks once I am finished. I have my full setup. I can edit. I have my ring light, which is also from Amazon, and it just works. The only thing that's kind of bugging me is the cords, but maybe I'll fix that later. It's temporary, so I don't really have to. So I found these really nice lights at Walmart. Yes, Walmart. And they're slim under the cabinet lighting, and you can put this pretty much under any shelf or any cabinet, but I'm going to put it underneath this shelf that's behind me because there's no light, and I wanted something to be, you know, very seamless and off of the desk, because this is a smaller desk and I didn't want to take up too much room. But this one here was like, I think, $12. So I'm going to mount this underneath my shelf using some nano tape. I love this stuff, guys. Yes, the desk is from Amazon. The chair is from Amazon. And this chair is actually super duper comfortable. And it's crazy because I ordered it twice, which I ended up wasting $40. So I will go ahead and let you guys know that Wayfair sells this chair too, but they want $150 for it. I scored it on Amazon for like a little bit under $110. I don't know the exact amount, but it wasn't $140. So yeah, don't order it from Wayfair. Make sure you get it from Amazon. If you are interested, I'll show you guys a little bit more of how this chair looks. But yeah, so the area that I have back here is pretty much, you know, just my desk, some shelving, the little gold hanging, or the little gold folder holder is from Amazon as well. And the shelves are from Home Depot. This white bookshelf is from IKEA, and my rug is from Ross. So that's pretty much where everything is from. But I'm gonna give you guys a more in-depth look at things, so don't worry. I use the bookshelf for more of a decorative statement piece, more so in the living room. And if you guys didn't see my DIY, I have a bunch of them. But this one here is from the Dollar Tree, and I'm so proud of it.
I just didn't want to spend any more money on this. But yeah, I'll get more in detail with this when I do the living room tour. So anyway, back over here to this little nook area of an office. The desk is from Amazon, and I had this little acrylic organizer for my makeup a long time ago, but I didn't throw it away because you guys know I love acrylic. And I use it to store a lot of my stationery, pens, you know, clips, things like that. I love these little magnets. They're just very inspirational, and I like all of my organization or stationery to be colorful. And then I have some pens that I've found from TJ Maxx, and they're just very on trend with my pink. So, and then I had these hole punches from a long, long time ago. I used to be addicted to Michaels, like, it was bad back in my jewelry making days. This little acrylic ruler is so cute to me, and I picked it up from this little pop-up store in Buckhead when I lived in Atlanta. And it just, I don't know, it's so cute to me. So that's pretty much all that's in here. And then I have a stapler, a gold stapler from Target, which I actually should put out, but I don't like so much stuff to be out. These pens right here, these colorful felt tip pens are the bomb. I love them. I got them from TJ Maxx. And these are from the Dollar Tree. These are from Michaels, just some washi tape. I use it in my planner sometimes. And then of course, just regular paper clips and thank you notes. Never know when you gotta say thank you. Moving on to this drawer over here, I have highlighters in here, and let me backtrack. These containers here are from Target, and I was going back and forth because initially I was gonna use some pink cheaper acrylic, well, no, not they were plastic. I was gonna use some pink plastic organizers instead of the acrylic because these were a little bit more pricier. However, once I put them in here, I was like, no, I'm not proud of this drawer. So I took those back and I ended up just investing in these, which I need to take the stickers off, but that'll be for another day. So like I said, in here, I keep my highlighters as well as this really cool, this is an all-in-one screwdriver, and I got this from the Dollar Tree. But the reason I keep this in here is because I'm always needing to rescrew something or something, I don't know, and it just has all of the attachments in here. So I was like, ooh, perfect. So I keep it in here instead of having to go get a whole toolbox just to, you know, get a screwdriver. And then I keep a box cutter because I'm always receiving packages. So why not just keep a box cutter somewhere handy? Over here is where I keep my notepads. And here I keep, you know, like extra cards and white out. I don't even know if anybody, yeah, I use this still when I'm trying to transcribe some notes, my paper weight. And then some more sticky pads. I love these I'm so excited about. Look at these, y'all, this is so pretty. I got these from the Dollar Tree. Yes, the Dollar Tree quid plan, and they are just the cutest, right? You got a stack of papers, you need to paper clip them, you're gonna be happy with these. And then I have some binder rings, and over here I have my, what is this, my insignia. This is actually where I plug this in back behind my computer, and then I plug it into here, and then I can put my memory cards in here instead of having to reach all the way behind the computer and put the memory card in, which is such a pain in the butt. So yes, that is what is in my two drawers. Okay, so moving on, on top of my desk, I have this really cute Dollar Tree. I think this is a candle holder, but I ended up using it as a pen holder because I got all these beautiful pens from TJ Maxx. I ended up buying two packs, but something about these pens are just so beautiful, and they're felt tip, they write great, I love them. So these are my pens, and I don't know if you guys can see the theme. I really love that bespeckled look. I like black and white, cream, blush pink, bespeckled, stripes, that type of stuff. And this here is from the Dollar Tree as well. Yeah, Dollar Tree is really coming on with come on. This cute little candle holder, which I turned into a flower vase, is from TJ Maxx. And then I got this bouquet of flowers from I want to say Michael's Arts and Crafts, and this was already put together. So I just bent this up and just dropped it in here. And I ended up getting a discount because this is broken, which I have no problem with because, you know, I'm just going to turn it around to the back. It was originally $12.99, but I think I paid like $8, $7 or something like that. So I'm just showing you guys all my little secrets, but it looked good though. So moving up, I have this cute little gold rag that holds my folders, and I purchased it from Amazon, like I said earlier. And originally, this was not the color that I wanted it to be. It was like this crazy high gloss gold. So I purchased some gold spray paint from Amazon as well, and I will link that. It's in my Amazon store. But this is the perfect gold. Like, it matches this type of gold, it matches that gold. It's like perfect. So I spray painted it and it blended in perfectly. The folders are from Target, and they're by the brand sugar paper. They're the sugar paper brand, and I love these. They feel so good. They feel like they have like a textured feel to them. But yeah, I just keep my papers here, incoming, outgoing, to do, and receipts. I keep them all in here. The picture frame is from the Dollar Tree. I spray painted it white, and I thought it would look perfect because I had this picture here from IKEA that I got out of the as-is section. It came with like three pictures. I think I paid like $2 for it, all three. And then I purchased this candle. It's Namaste from the Dollar Tree. Yep, your girl scored big. It just took me a while to find everything. So this was $1, and then the orchid is from IKEA. That was actually full price. However, this was only $1, and I got it from the as-is section. So I like it because it has like that cement look, and I don't know if you guys kind of catch on, but I love like that organic look. I like cement, wood, stones, that type of stuff. So moving over here, I purchased this decor piece from TJ Maxx, and it was $40. This is actually from Tahari Home, and I just really liked it because it had more of a chic glam kind of look. And the shelves, if I didn't mention, are from Home Depot. And if you guys saw my last video where I made the tray, the smaller tray is the cardboard that I used. So the packaging that it came in, I ended up creating a new shelf, and I absolutely love it. If you guys haven't seen it, I'll link that video down below. But yeah, I ended up getting two different sizes. This one's a little bit longer than this one, so that it could just have that kind of like that staggered look. It's almost as if I have one shelf going across, but it stops and then it's like there. See, my mind is crazy. I knew I wanted one shelf, but then I was like, no, I don't want one shelf, I want two shelves. So I just, boom, boom. Yeah, and I was done with that. Then moving over to the corner, what's a desk without books? So I ended up DIYing these books, and I believe that's in the same video as the shelf that I was just talking about, so you will see that also. But then I also had these books from the Goodwill from a while ago, and what I love about them is that they're white and they have gold writing, and I actually like the titles. So I ended up pairing them with the white books just so that they would have, you know, like a nice soft look instead of just a stark white, because these are more white, this is more cream. And then I seen these these are album books from the Dollar Tree, and I was like, ooh, I gotta get one of these. So I've been trying to like put my pictures together because they're like in a box, and I just want them to be in a nice photo album, and I really love the design. So these are from the Dollar Tree as well. Now, the last thing that I want to show you guys is the wall grid. This is from the Dollar Tree as well. This is actually a kitchen cookie rack, I want to say, or I don't know, it was $1. So all I did was pull off some of the wires and spray painted it black, and I just hung it up using the push pins that I showed you guys in a DIY not too long ago. Put one up here, one down there, and it's perfect. This is so rental friendly because when you pull it out, you can't even see the hole. It looks like a little bug is on the wall or something like that. But this is perfect for any renter. And you know, if I get cards, I usually put them up there, or if I have cards that I want to send out or anything like that. And plus, it just looks good. But yeah, that is pretty much all of the desk. Like I said, the desk is from Amazon, and this is a iMac, and I use the Magic Trackpad sometimes, but again, this is not my number one workspace.
All right, guys, so I hope that you guys like my little desk areas and workstations. Like I said, when you work from home, you have to be creative, because sometimes if you have ADHD, like me, you cannot sit in the same place and do a lot of work because you just get anxious and nothing gets done. So if you guys like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you found value in this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you're not already subscribed, what you waiting on? This is all I do over here, is figure out stuff and show you guys. So as always, guys, don't forget, be you, be beautiful, be chic on a budget, and I will see you guys on my next upload. Bye, guys.